Freedom Daily News. Entitled Black Thug Inspired by NFL Player Protests Shows Up to Milwaukee School with Sixer Prize for Teacher. Violence seems to be an accepted part of our culture right now. Riots, protests, you name it, it is being perpetrated by liberals in our streets. It is completely unacceptable but incentivized under the former administration. But this administration is having none of it. Which is why this recent example of violence against a teacher no less should not shock you whatsoever. Fox 6 recently reported the following. A teacher at South Division High School was punched by a student. The whole thing was captured on camera. The video shows a student punching a teacher several times in the head. That student, not just in trouble with the school but also with police. A confrontation between a student and a teacher escalates to violence. A cell video records from the back of the classroom as a 16-year-old is seen shoving his teacher. Eventually, punching him repeatedly in the head. The man falls to the ground as the teen keeps hitting him. The circumstances around the fight aren't known. Police say the student was arrested at the school and faces possible charges of battery. A Milwaukee Public School spokesman says the district is cooperating with the investigation. MPS is cooperating with the Milwaukee Police Department to investigate a situation that occurred today at 1515 West Lapham Boulevard. Due to this being an ongoing investigation, we cannot comment further. A school that's known as the Fighting Cardinals now dealing with a fight of a different kind. Police tell Fox 6 the teacher's injuries were not life-threatening. Charges will be presented to the district attorney's office in the coming days. Officials say the case will be presented to the Milwaukee County District Office in the coming days for possible charges of battery to a school district official. Milwaukee Alderman Bob Donovan issued the following statement on this incident. Violence at MPS is a great concern to the community. Actions like this need criminal charges to send a message, and hold the student responsible for their reckless and dangerous behavior. I applaud the many great teachers and students at MPS, however, there is a segment of students who choose to behave inappropriately and criminally, which robs other students and teachers of an opportunity to build a safe learning environment. Jerry Girth, a parent of a student at the South Division High School, said the following about the vicious attack. It makes me mad. Somebody didn't teach your child enough respect to say don't swing at a teacher. You don't swing at an adult. You don't disrespect adults. Milwaukee Alderman Bob Donovan made a statement about the attack. Violence at MPS is a great concern to the community. Actions like this need criminal charges to send a message, and hold the student responsible for their reckless and dangerous behavior. I applaud the many great teachers and students at MPS, however, there is a segment of students who choose to behave inappropriately and criminally, which robs other students and teachers of an opportunity to build a safe learning environment. He also unequivocally stated, I think anyone who would view the video would be disturbed. Anytime you see an attack like that, and it was a vicious attack, I condemn this violent attack and the reckless disregard for human life it shows. I most definitely believe he needs to be prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law. A message needs to be sent to other young people. South Division High School student Landon Walker spoke out saying, I expect more from South Division. I thought we were going to do something better about this year, but apparently I was wrong. Police said the teacher's injuries are non-life-threatening. Police said they are handing the case to the Milwaukee County District Attorney's Office for possible charges of battery to a school official. I most definitely believe he needs to be prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law. A message needs to be sent to other young people, Donovan said. An MPS spokesperson said the district is cooperating with police but cannot comment further. The teacher's name is not being released, but one staffer told WISN 12 News the school community is very concerned because he is described as a beloved teacher there. This type of behavior is completely unacceptable and should never be tolerated. It is sadly unfortunate that after dedicating oneself to teaching the younger generation, this teacher was attacked for doing his job. Yet the mainstream liberal media has not been complaining about it or reporting on it. Behavior like this should never be tolerated, and there should be a zero tolerance policy. If not, the system is guilty of incentivizing this behavior. Justice must come, and if the police department does their due diligence as well as the district attorney's office, then justice will surely be viable. It is definitely the violence in our streets and amongst celebrity athletes that perpetuates behavior like this by making it look like it is cool. Of course, it is anything but that. What are kids supposed to think when people break glass windows and tear down monuments, and when professional MLB and NFL players get into physical fights? We must lead by example. And right now we are not doing that by glorifying such grotesque behavior and antics. No doubt by the end of Trump's term this type of thing will be a thing of the past, and you won't see any media outlets reporting on it, because hopefully, it won't exist anymore.